We'll get off the couch and a host this week. What? Let's go. Oh, let's go.
My bad.
Let's go.
Come on.
Hey, Woolies.
So, we got the football game Friday night, which is also senior night.
We also have trick-or-treating where us seniors are handing candy out to the underclassmen.
Now, Logan, what are you going as for this?
If I had to go, I'd say I'd definitely go as Batman.
Good choice, good choice.
And then, don't forget to stay tuned for our Halloween special, which we hope to see some of you folks watch.
Get ready for a Frostastic interview.
Hey, boys. My name's Ian, and this is...
Miss Frosto.
And today we're going to be asking Miss Frosto some questions about being a new teacher at the school. So, Miss Frosto.
Yes.
How long have you been teaching at MHS so far?
This is my second year here. I started at the beginning of last year.
And what classes are you teaching this year?
So currently I'm teaching the 7th grade art classes and the 8th grade art classes, as well as animation, digital photography, and graphic design for high schoolers.
Very cool, very cool. Also, if you were to give advice to your younger self, what would it be?
Oh, jeez. Probably just that, like, nobody actually cares about stuff as much as you care about it. So, like, you work yourself up about things in your head so much more than you need to. And I still do it now, but I think, like, definitely good advice is just, like, don't be so stressed out about the things that you stress out about.
I agree. That is really good advice. Now, lastly, what were you involved in when you were in high school? Like, what clubs?
When I was in high school, I did student council, I was in the National Honor Society, the Spanish Honor Society, I did the two art clubs that were in my school, and then I did the unified sports at my school, and I did volleyball all 4 years.
Very fun and cool. Thank you for your time.
Of course, happy to be here.
That was a great segment with Ms. Frosto.
What do you think? It was really great.
Next up, we got the drama crew interview with Mr. Seeger, the new drama teacher.
Mark Jakubiak.
Pretty interested to see about that.
I'm here with Mr. Seeger, the new drama club director, and Mark, the production assistant for the fall play. We're going to ask them a few questions about the drama club, the fall play, and the musical. So, Mr. Seeger, introduce yourself to the wonderful world of MHS.
Hi, Woolies. So, my name is Joel Seeger, and I am the new drama club director. I'm excited to be here for the first time this year, working on the fall play and then the spring musical. I've been doing theater a very long time. My first role that I remember doing on stage, fun fact, I was a dancing and singing marshmallow in Hansel and Gretel in the 3rd grade. Yes, I wore white tights. Yes, I wore a cone hat. I still have nightmares about it, but all these years later, many, many, many years later, this is what I do full time. It's where I met my wife doing theater, and I have a lot of friends who do theater professionally all over the world. And this is what I do. I work with kids. This year, I'll be working with 4 different school districts, and I'll be producing 8 different shows between November and June of this year. So a busy time.
Alrighty, and Mark, introduce yourself.
Hey, I'm Mark. I'm the production assistant. Last year, I was crew.
Our first question is, what is the fall play? I mean, we sort of have a set going on here, but what's the play? We'll start with Mark.
It is Mission Possible. It's about detectives figuring out who the evil guy is. You probably have a better description.
That's good. I would agree with that, yes. Mission Possible, it's a spy spoof. So like those old-timey spy movies and TV shows, and we have a lot of characters that are based on some popular characters. So if you don't know them, maybe your parents or grandparents know some of the characters, and they're all worked into one story, so we don't have James Bond, but we have James Bond, and things like that. So it's a funny spy spoof. We don't have Goldfinger, that's a popular like James Bond evil character. We have Silver Thumb in the play, so Will's playing our lead, and he is Silver Thumb instead of Goldfinger. So it's gonna be a good time, we're excited.
Alrighty, yes, I will be playing Silver Thumb, so if you wanna come see me act like a villain, come on to the play. When is the fall play?
When is the fall play? That's a really good question. Thank you for asking, Will. It's in November. It's November... Is it the 11th? November 22, 23, 24. So we are very excited. It's going to be a good time. Before that, you'll hear about the spring musical, though.
And, you know, speaking of musical, what are your big plans for the Drama Club? This question can go to Mark, too. What are big plans you want to do for this year?
So, big plans. That's actually a really good question, because today we got a very large donation from CNS Lumber. They are a tenth of a mile. They're basically in the next street over. We got a major donation from them in the form of lumber. So we'll be able to build all new flats for enough for the play and even leftover material to help us build stuff for the musical. So we're very excited. It was a very large donation. It came in a very large truck for a very small pile, but we have photos. Hopefully you'll see that on our social media posts later on. But we're excited. So that was the first thing, is to make sure that we could have new set pieces. So we're building those starting next week. So we're excited about that. And that will give us material left over, like I said, to start planning the build for the musical.
And Mark, as a production assistant, any big plans?
I just hope that we can get this fundraiser committee on so we can start a bake sale for the Drama Club so we can have money to get more costumes and props and painting material for the sets.
Alrighty, and then our last question we have, I know you're not going to reveal it here, but any possible hints for the spring musical?
So here are the hints for the spring musical, officially. It was a Broadway show within the past, I'm going to go far, I'm going to say 15 years. It was a Broadway show. I saw it on Broadway. I knew somebody in the cast. I got a backstage tour and met some of the performers. That's a big hint, but you guys don't know me or my history, so maybe it's not. But all of that is 100% true. It is a show that I have never produced before, and it is a show that you have not done here at Millbury, and I don't think it's been done in the area at all. So we may be like a little premiere for the show.
It's groundbreaking.
So it's a big show. It's a big show. I'm excited.
Well, thank you, Mr. Seeger, and thank you, Mark, for helping out. Make sure you follow the Drama Club on Instagram to keep up with when this musical is going to get revealed.
That's right.
All right, thank you, Willie.
Stay tuned for what Aiden has planned for us.
Him and Miss Hammer will be saying their top five greatest artists.
Boys, today I'm here with Miss Hammer.
Hey.
And we're going to be doing a draft of the top five greatest artists of all time. You can start.
Okay. I'm going to go Michael Jackson. King of pop. Go ahead.
I'm going to go Elvis Presley.
Ooh, that was a good one. Since we're not doing bands, I was gonna do the Beatles, but I'm gonna go with Paul McCartney.
Yes, he's very good. I'm gonna go with Whitney Houston.
Ooh, that's also a really good one. I'm gonna go with Aretha Franklin.
Very good. Queen of Soul.
Mm-hmm. This is a good list. I'm getting a little panicked here.
I'm going to go with Johnny Cash.
Oh. I'm going to go with a little bit more of a modern one. I don't feel like I can have a list without the Swifties.
Oh,
or
wow.
I'm going to get in trouble.
I'm going to go with Billy Joel.
Oh. I'll go Beyonce.
That's very good. Tom Petty.
Like, that's a good list, but I feel like we're missing some.
Go in the comments and vote for who you think had the better draft.
Thanks for watching, Woolies.
Have a great Friday.
And
happy Halloween!